So hi everyone and very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. In today's class, in today's session, we are going to talk about the PIB news from 3rd and 4th of December 2022. And I hope your preparations for RBI Grade B 2023 are going well. Please don't wait for the notification. Notification to aayega hi, use aana hi hoga. Then why you guys are waiting for the notification? Just start your preparation from today only. Theek hai? जल्दी से अपना फेज टू का सिलेबस खत्म करो और जल्दी से उसकी रिवीजन स्टार्ट करो. राइट, प्लीज डोंट वेट फॉर द नोटिफिकेशन. इट इज द राइट टाइम फॉर प्रिपरेशन. ठीक है, आप इसी इंतजार में मत रहा करो कि चलो ठीक है, हम राइट टाइम का इंतजार मत किया करो कि सही समय आएगा तो हम पढ़ना स्टार्ट करेंगे. प्लीज डोंट डू दैट. इट इज द राइट टाइम टू स्टार्ट योर प्रिपरेशन, टू गियर अप योर सेल्फ. राइट, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन विद द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विच सेज Ministry of Civil Aviation, which is headed by Jyotiraditya Sindhya, right, recently notified the operational guidelines for implementation of the PLI scheme for drones and drone components in India. So you have to identify the correct statement about this scheme. Right, we have discussed this scheme so many times before this as well. But आप में से कई लोग ऐसे होते हैं जो नए नए जुड़ते हैं चैनल से, तो उनके लिए ये है. इस स्कीम के बारे में थोड़ा सा डिस्कस कर लेंगे. It is the news because as the question says, the operational guidelines for the scheme has been launched, right? But since it is in news, it is our duty to discuss it, right? So what is the objective of this scheme? Of course, objective kisi bhi scheme ka we can easily derive from its name itself, right? So the objective of this scheme is to incentivize the manufacturing of drones and its components. Jo bhi drone manufacturers hai ya phir jo drone ke components ke manufacturers hai, those manufacturers will be incentivized by the Ministry of Civil Aviation through this scheme, right? And this incentive will be production linked, right? That is the basic genesis of production linked incentive schemes, right? It was launched this year only, in the year 2022, for a period up to financial year 2025, which means up to 31st March 2025, right? And the total outlay for this scheme, guys, is 120 crores. Moving ahead, so eligibility criteria. So which all manufacturers can have the benefit of this scheme. So the support will be provided only to those companies who are engaged in the manufacturing of drone or drone components in India, right? Kisi foreign company ko isme koi support nahi diya jayega. Only those companies who are registered in India will be provided with the support under this scheme, right? And this is the minimum annual sales turnover for claiming PLI. If it is an Indian MSME and startup, then drone component, drone ke liye rupees 2 crore should be the minimum turnover. For component, it is 50 lakhs or you can say 0.5 crores. If it is a non-MSME manufacturing company, then in that case, drone ke case mein uska 4 crore rupees hona chahiye minimum annual turnover. And in case of component, it should be more than or equal to 1 crores. राइट, तो इतना मिनिमम एनुअल सेल्स टर्नओवर होना चाहिए, ओनली देन द मैन्युफैक्चरर और द कंपनी विल बी एलिजिबल टू गेट द बेनिफिट अंडर दिस स्कीम. आई होप द स्कीम इज क्लियर एंड नाउ लेट्स ट्राई टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. इट विल बी इंप्लीमेंटेड फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 8 years. इज दैट सो? नो, इट विल बी इंप्लीमेंटेड स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम दिस फाइनेंशियल ईयर टू फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2024-25, व्हिच मींस दिस स्टेटमेंट इज इनकरेक्ट. इट हैज टोटल आउटले ऑफ 120 crore. सही बात है, बिल्कुल, नो प्रॉब्लम. Under it, financial support will be provided to companies engaged in the manufacturing of drones and drone components in India as well as in foreign countries. Why would government provide production linked incentive to the foreign companies? Of course, it is incorrect. For MSME and startups to claim PLI, their annual sales turnover should be rupees 2 crore for drones and rupees 50 lakh for components segment. Ye bilkul sahi hai. While for non-MSME, it is 4 crore and 1 crore respectively. And for non-MSMEs, yes, the next statement is this only, 4 crore and 1 crore. So if I have to identify the correct statement, so 2, 4 and 5. Yeah, option D, 2, 4 and 5 guys will be the correct answer. I hope this question is clear. Let's move ahead to question number 2. This scheme is about scheme for facilitating startups, intellectual property protection scheme, right? So this scheme, again, the question arises that why we are discussing about this scheme? Because isme koi fees hai jo inhone increase kar di hai. It is not a new scheme. It was launched in the year 2016. But whenever any scheme is in news, you have to study that scheme, right? Because aise hi cheezon se exam mein question aayega. Examiner aisa thodi hai ki jayega 2005 में और ढूंढेगा कि 2005 में कौन सी स्कीम लॉन्च हुई थी, तो चलो उससे क्वेश्चन बनाते हैं। ऐसा नहीं होता है। उस वो स्कीम किसी ना किसी रीजन से न्यूज में होगी, तभी वो क्वेश्चन एग्जाम में आता है। बट यस, इन आरबीआई, अगर मैं आरबीआई की बात करता हूं तो स्टैटिक स्कीम से भी क्वेश्चन आते हैं, तो उसके लिए हम अलग से क्लास कंडक्ट करेंगे वंस द नोटिफिकेशन इज आउट, राइट। सो स्कीम फॉर फैसिलिटेटिंग स्टार्टअप्स इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी प्रोटेक्शन वॉज लॉन्च इन 2016 टू प्रोटेक्ट एंड प्रमोट द इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी राइट्स ऑफ स्टार्टअप्स एंड टू एनकरेज इनोवेशन एंड क्रिएटिविटी अमंग देम। So you have to identify the incorrect statement among all these statements, right? So let's talk about this scheme. Why it is in news? Because the professional charges of the facilitators of the scheme has been increased by the ministry, right? Professional charges of the facilitators. Now ye facilitators kaun hote hain, kya karte hain, abhi samjhenge, don't worry. I am just telling you this, that why it is in news. It is in news because under this scheme, the professional charges of the facilitators have been increased by the ministry, right? Now let's talk about this scheme. What is this scheme? So as the name suggests, right, as the name suggests, the objective of this scheme is to protect and promote the intellectual property rights of the startups and thereby creative and also to create innovation and creativity amongst them, right? That is the basic objective, launch year 2016. And yes, some people, guys, one thing very important, some people आर आस्किंग कि यार हमसे लॉन्च ईयर जो है वो याद नहीं हो पाता है। सो आई एम वर्किंग ऑन दिस एंड आई एम डेफिनेटली प्रोबेबली दिस वीक और नेक्स्ट वीक एक बहुत ही अच्छी चीज मैं आपके सामने लेके आऊंगा, हाउ टू रिमेंबर द लॉन्च ईयर, राइट। कैसे आप लॉन्च ईयर्स को याद कर सकते हो, इसके बारे में भी हम डिस्कस करेंगे। एक सेपरेट वीडियो इसके ऊपर आएगी, सो प्लीज वेट फॉर दैट वीडियो, ठीक है। तो उससे आपका लॉन्च ईयर वाला जो प्रॉब्लम है वो भी सॉर्ट हो जाए। आई एम ट्राइंग कि मैं आपके लिए कुछ अच्छा, कुछ इनोवेटिव सा लेके आऊं ताकि आप लॉन्च ईयर जो आपको याद करने में प्रॉब्लम हो रही है वो ना हो। ओके, सो इन 2020 रिमेंबर दिस स्कीम वाज एक्सटेंडेड फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 3 इयर्स एंड इट इज करेंटली एप्लीकेबल अप टू 31 मार्च 2023, राइट। एंड द इम्प्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी फॉर दिस स्कीम इज ऑफिस ऑफ द कंट्रोलर जनरल ऑफ पेटेंट डिजाइंस एंड ट्रेडमार्क्स which works under DPIIT, and DPIIT works under what? The Ministry of Commerce and Industry, which means if anyone asks you that which ministry is the nodal ministry for this scheme, the answer would be Ministry of Commerce and Industry, which is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal. Of course, I hope you all know this. Ministry, bata diya maine aapko, it facilitates, right? Under the scheme, the Office of Controller General of Patent Design facilitates startups in filling and processing of their patent design or trademark application through the assistance of IP facilitators. So these are the facilitators. मैंने आपको शुरू में बताया था facilitators ये करते क्या हैं? They help startups in processing of their IP forms, of their trademark forms, etc. And under it, of course, जब facilitators होंगे तो उनको पैसे तो देने पड़ेंगे, फ्री में थोड़ी ना सेवा मिलेगी भाई। So they will be they are being provided with the facilitation fees of these for these services which they are providing to the startups, and these fees are being, you know, ye jo fees hai ye kaun pay karta hai? Controller General of Patent Design and Trademarks, right? So abhi ye news mein tha kyunki fees bada di hai, ab ye fees hai kuch nahi, to aapko yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai. At the time of filling of application kitna hai ye? पेटेंट्स के लिए है 15,000, ट्रेडमार्क के लिए 3,000, डिजाइन के लिए 3,000. यू डोंट हैव टू रिमेंबर दीज फीस, राइट। ये आपको याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है। सो लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन नाउ एंड लेट्स आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट। इट फैसिलिटेट स्टार्टअप्स इन फिलिंग एंड प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ देयर पेटेंट डिजाइन, सही है। इट इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय ऑफिस ऑफ कंट्रोलर जनरल ऑफ पेटेंट डिजाइन एंड ट्रेडमार्क, करेक्ट। इट हैज बीन एक्सटेंडेड फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 3 इयर्स टिल 31 मार्च 2023, नो प्रॉब्लम। Under it, facilitation fees of IP facilitators are borne by the startups themselves. No, this fees is being borne by the Office of Controller General of Patent Design and Trademarks. So this is the incorrect, which means option D, guys, is the correct answer. I hope this question is also clear. Let's talk about question number 3. Where has the workshop cum buyer seller meet been organized by Agricultural and Processed Food Export Development Authority, which in short is APIDA. I hope you all know this. Agricultural and Processed Food Export Development Authority, to give a boost to the export of agricultural organic agricultural products of the northeastern region, right? So it took place in Aizawl in Mizoram. It took place in Aizawl, and the objective was already mentioned in the question. Why this meet was organized? To give a boost to the export of organic agricultural products from the northeastern region, right? And the detailed objective ho gaya iske, and it was organized by APIDA in association with Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare and Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Uske alawa Mizoram government and Northeastern Regional Agricultural Marketing Corporation Limited. These are the 4-5 bodies which together organize this meet. Alright. That is all. Isse zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Agar isme se question aaya to wo yahi hoga ya to organizer ka hoga question. That which organized was the nodal organizer. So nodal organizer was APIDA. Right? Ya fir agar sare hi pooch le ki kaun kis kis ne milke kiya tha. To wo ho sakta hai ya fir the place jahan pe isko organize kiya gaya. So therefore the correct answer is what? Option D. Aizawl. Aizawl is the correct answer. Question number 4. Where was the first of its kind Millet Smart Nutritive Food Conclave was organized as a pre-launch event of the International Year of Millets 2023 by Ministry of Commerce and Industry as a... Okay, ye repeat ho gaya. Theek hai? By Ministry of Commerce and Industry. So, kahan pe isko organize kiya gaya tha? So, as the name suggests, it was conducted to create awareness about the millet, about the nutritious value of millets, right? That is why it was organized, hai na? The major objective was to promote the export of millets, and it was organized by Ministry of Commerce and Industry through APIDA. Theek hai, isko bhi kisne kiya tha? Organized APIDA through its apex agricultural export promotion body, which is APIDA, right? So the nodal agency to organize this conclave was APIDA, which is Agricultural and Processed Food Export Development Authority. Alright, and it took place in New Delhi. Therefore, the correct answer is again option D, New Delhi. I hope this is also clear. Let's talk about, okay, ye thoda sa millet ke baare mein, ye thoda sa information hai. This is important because, of course, we all know that 2023 is the International Year of Millets. So, we should know basic facts about India and millets. So, remember, India is the India is one of the largest producer of millets in the world with an estimated share of around 40% of the global millet production. Jo ki bahut bada percentage hai, right? Top 5 millet producing states kaun se hamare desh mein? This is also important. Do remember it. Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh. These are the 5 top millet producing state in the country. The share of export of millet, it is nearly 1% of the total millet production, and there is an organization which is Nutri Cereals Export Promotion Forum, which was constituted by the government to give an impetus to the export of potential products including millets, right? And of course to remove the bottlenecks in the supply chain wherever the millets and the related products are involved, right? So ये कुछ बेसिक फैक्ट्स हैं और भी बेसिक फैक्ट्स इन फ्यूचर निकल के आएंगे बिकॉज वी ऑल नो दैट नेक्स्ट ईयर इट इज द इंटरनेशनल ईयर ऑफ मिलेट्स राइट लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 देन नेशनल अवार्ड्स फॉर द एम्पावरमेंट ऑफ पर्सन विद डिसेबिलिटीज आर गिवन एवरी ईयर अर्लियर दिस अवार्ड स्कीम वॉज गवर्न अंडर द नेशनल अवार्ड्स रूल 2013 विच प्रोवाइडेड 7 कैटेगरीज ऑफ डिसेबिलिटीज एज पर पीडब्ल्यूडी एक्ट ऑफ 1995 हाउएवर विद द कमिंग इनटू फोर्स ऑफ Rights of Person with Disabilities Act of 2016, the number of specialized disabilities under these awards has been increased from 7 to what? So, as you know guys, when there was this act, PWD Act of 1995, there were 7 class of disabilities, right? 7 types of disabilities which were recognized. But after enacting of this act, right, after replacement of PWD Act of 1995 by Act of 2016, the number of disabilities were increased from 7 to 21. And that's why iska jo answer hoga, wo bhi kitna hoga? 21. Option D is the correct answer. Question number 6. Where was the Swar Dharohar Festival organized by the Ministry of Culture to showcase the iconic art and culture, rich literary art and heritage of Indian states? Very easy question and very direct question. There is no need to go into the details, of course. Option E, New Delhi, is the correct answer. Question number 7, very important. बहुत सारा चांसेस है कि ये क्वेश्चन आपके एग्जाम में आए. Who has assumed the charge as the chairperson of National Commission for Backward Classes? Remember, National Commission for Backward Classes was established in 1993 as the statutory body, right? As the statutory body, but through 102nd Constitutional Amendment Act of 2018, it was given the constitutional status. It was given the constitutional status. So now it is a constitutional body. So there must be an article. Yes, this body is governed by Article number 338 D of the Constitution of India. And Mr. Hans Raj here has been appointed as the chairperson of National Commission for Backward Classes. Where was the National Workshop on Natural Farming recently organized by the Agricultural Technology Application Research Institute? Again, very direct question. There is no need of details of this. It took place in Gwalior. Option C is the correct answer. 9 pe aa jate hain. Where was the first Sherpa meeting of India's G20 presidency held? So as you all know, India is now the president of G20. So bahut sari cheeze isme aayengi, exam mein bhi puchi jayengi. G20 se question aana confirm samajh lo, theek hai. So the first Sherpa meeting, who is the Sherpa by the way? Amitabh Kant, the ex CEO of Niti Aayog. Amitabh Kant is the Sherpa of India's G20 presidency, and first Sherpa meeting took place in Udaipur, which is in Rajasthan, of course. Option D is the correct answer. And the last question for today, which organization has started Nirman Se Shakti initiative to strengthen and modernize the infrastructure of hospitals and dispensaries in a phased manner? So Nirman Se Shakti, it was started by ESIC, which is Employees State Insurance Corporation. Option D is the correct answer. All right guys, so that's it for today's session. If you want to have the PDF of this session, join the Telegram channel. Agar aapko PDF chahiye to jaake Telegram channel join karo. The link is provided in the description. And if you want to have the all round preparation of all the government exams, you can download the Anujindala. All right, so thank you so much. I will see you in the next session. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.